In May, the Jordanese actor, Elsa Walker, passed away while playing in a death scene. Molière, the famous French playwright, had a stroke, performing in his own play, Le Malade Imaginaire, a play about a death prophecy. He would die that same night. Fiction suddenly becomes reality. I'm Chris Nietvelt, and I'm an actress at the ensemble of Toneelgroep Amsterdam, and this is our house. This is my home. And I have died here quite often. My characters' souls have risen here more than 200 times in about 19 plays. And since I took part in the event The Art of Dying last September, I've even been nicknamed the Queen of the Death Scene. I've been killed by a knife, choked to death. I've committed suicide by taking poison, by walking into the sea. I've been bitten by a venomous snake. I've passed away from severe illnesses, and not to mention all the characters I've played that were about to die when the play ended. And the question an actor often hears is, how can you portray something that you have never experienced, that you can barely imagine? How do you know how to die? I don't know. But we don't know. But the arts are able to they are able to intensify reality, and in that way to intensify our experience. So the question is not knowing how to die or how to empathize with something so intangible as a dying person, but how to shape the intangible. This is how my Lady Macbeth died. During the whole play, I was wearing a latex mask that was formed according to my own face. And while dying, I peeled the mask off. Lady Macbeth was revealing her true person, my true face. And then she died. Or another one. The play Cries and Whispers that Ivo van Hoven made at Toneelgroep Amsterdam. A play completely about death. Agnes, an artist, is dying. And surrounded by her friend and caregiver and her two sisters, we see her in the last phase of her life. I was Agnes. And the play portrays the decline, the pain, the vomit, the shit, but also the intimacy, the love, the sadness, shamelessly, and followed by the ultimate moment, the final breath. And we showed how Agnes, carefully embraced by the women around her, slowly let go of life. However, often this is not the way it goes. And we also wanted to show that, the other side. So I didn't die once, but twice. And this time, fighting death, heavily resisting, shouting, screaming, and like you see, all in blue paint. Agnes is an artist. The audience was really touched. And they and we could not grasp it really with our brain. Why do we experience death, and even an artificial one, with such intensity? The death scene confronts us with that what we cannot or do not want to imagine, that eventually we will not be here anymore. To be or not to be? That's the question. And we cannot solve the question. But our imagination, and that's what Einstein already said, imagination is more important than knowledge. Knowledge is limited to that what we know and what we understand, but imagination can embrace the world and all that is yet to come to know and to understand. Art is not an ornament, but it can be a lens that reveals reality. I will die for you now. And I hope to stir your imagination. Johan Simons and Paul Cook created a play called Sentimenti, a very simple story about a laborer family with two sons, and they combined it with music by Verdi. At the beginning of the play, we see an old woman at her deathbed, accompanied by her son, Simon, played by the late Dutch actor Jeroen Willems. I was the old woman, and Simon, at her deathbed, is looking back to the time where his mother fell in love with an Italian guest worker. And that could threaten the family. And then, at that moment, we jump back in time. And I became the young woman in love. And we follow the love affair until the moment the decision has to be made. Is she staying or is she leaving her family? And then, again, we jump back to reality. And I became the old woman again. And all I had to do, and that's what theater can do, to bridge the time is
do I look? You know what? I would love to smoke one now. Put some in the chest. What I want to ask, when did Daddy die? Has it been a year? It's things here. Like at the blacksmith. You know what? You know what I was just thinking? I must have loved the old guy. When I die so quickly after him, right?
Thank you.